Just like commercial branding, a single bold colour and a striking logo makes recognising a political party much easier, whether it's out on the campaign trail, on TV, or seeing who's winning on election night. Here's a look at some of the UK political parties' logos and colour schemes. Since the French Revolution, the colour red has been widely associated with left-wing politics, symbolically representing the blood of workers who died in their struggle against oppressors. When the British Labour Party was formed in 1900, a plain red flag was actually their emblem, but it was updated in 1986 to a red rose. Founded in 1834, the Conservative Party frequently uses the colours of the Union Jack, red, white and blue. The colour blue, particularly ultramarine, has long held connotations to wealth and conservatism, simply because it was traditionally the most expensive colour to produce. The party's current logo is an oak tree, the UK's national tree, harking back to the emblem of the original Tory party, the Royal Oak and Crown. The SNP first started campaigning with yellow and black rosettes in 1955, but the logo, a combination of the Scottish thistle and Scotland's flag, was created in 1962. Formed in 1988 from a merger of the Liberal Party and the Social Democratic Party, the Liberal Democrats' party colour is a combination of the two, orange. The logo they adopted was the Bird of Liberty symbol, which Margaret Thatcher famously mocked.
This is an ex-parrot.
Next up is the DUP. Whilst they're more ideologically similar to the Conservative Party and their colour scheme also draws on the Union Jack, there's much more red going on than you'd expect. The lion, whilst not native to either Northern Ireland or the UK, remains one of England's national symbols. Then there's the Green Party. They were originally called the Ecology Party until they changed their name in 1985. Green is a pretty obvious colour for a party with environmentalism at its core, and similarly, their logo is a sunflower. For the most part, the other parties in this election also adhere to the single dominant colour scheme, where the choice of colour not only represents the party, but also indicates a political ideology. So we normally associate the colour green with environmental movements, yellow's often linked to liberalism, black with anarchism or fascism, blue with conservatism, and red with socialism. And political parties in other countries tend to stick to this colour scheme too. The notable exception? The USA, where Democrats are blue and Republicans red. Colour plays a huge role in politics, but ultimately in this upcoming election, no matter what colour each party chooses, they all end up in black and white on the ballot paper, something that the Brexit Party hasn't overlooked.